Rick Hahn didn't like our guy John Heyman's response to a question about Pedro Grifol's status as a potential one-and-done guy and told reporters at The Rate yesterday that he has called Heyman for an explanation. Was Hahn upset for his hand-picked manager or for the inclusion of Hahn's status in the same question? Could Hahn be a 10-and-done guy? Do you believe he is at risk for the first time in his career?
Oh, boy. Yeah, I think that's pretty funny. 10-and-done. Although, didn't Theo, you know, kind of go to the whole Bill Walsh thing and say that the message kind of ends at a certain point?
I think Kenny actually has said that before.
Kenny said that
a decade on the job, then you start to look around.
Okay, well, I don't know. I honestly don't know what set Rick off a little bit. But he clearly didn't like, you know, the idea that Pedro is not going to be backed and fully committed to and all that. I think, you know, news travels slow when you're living in a bubble, in a vacuum. And maybe you don't hear this sort of thing. But really, a lot of our feelings about, you know, the idea that someone could be in trouble came from talking to Bob Nightingale, who everyone knows has like a pipeline inside the White Sox organization. He gets a lot of stuff right about the White Sox and seems to know what their thinking is. Now, is Rick privy to that? Is Rick thinking one way about his handpicked manager and maybe other people are looking at it and rolling their eyes? I don't know. But I think that when you hear enough kind of speculation about that, and really it does, I don't even need to hear anything. When you see how the team has performed, when you see what's going on with the White Sox, and what a huge disappointment. I mean, how about the idea that you got a guy setting the team franchise record in strikeouts and no one with that many strikeouts has lost before? Like, they lose the game anyway, right? Rick has this thing where he finally talks and you hear a little bit from him and he raises the standard and then they lose. I mean, this team's no damn good, man. I mean, this is not some kind of breakthrough. Oh my God, what do you mean? The Sox aren't great? Yeah, no, the Sox bad in a bad division. They are bad in it.
Well, there's obvious reason why he's upset. I mean, they're not playing good, and you don't want him to be like, oh, no problem. But I think he's misdirecting kind of his anger or sensitivity, if you will. But what are the chances, and we can all, he did not pick Tony La Russa to be the manager of the White Sox. I think we can all agree on that. No, nobody's putting Tony La Russa on Rick.
Do you remember the introductory Zoom conference?
Mm-hmm. But I don't think he's going to get three managers. So if Pedro's gone, Rick's gone, and Kenny might be gone. Now, Rick might be like moved around, maybe, if he would even take that. Maybe he wouldn't take that. Maybe he thinks he's got another shot in a different city with a different team, perhaps. But I can't see Rick Hahn getting a third manager.
Well, that's why I said earlier and referenced your guy Macbeth. This was full of sound and fury, signifying nothing, because the whole context of the question is not for him to answer. He isn't going to be the guy in my mind. If it's one and done, then everybody goes.
Right.
That means everybody's gone.
It's 10 and
that
done.
Means that there's been some sort of epiphany that I don't expect Jerry Reinsdorf to have or somebody at 35th and Shields to have that says, we've got to start over. So in his mind, I understand totally the pushback, and I recognize the defensiveness. It's every sports executive ever when they get called out on local radio by a national guy. But it does bear remembering this. As you point out, Mully, and as we have said and will continue to remind people, it was a second straight week that a national guy used Pedro Grifol as an example of a guy who's in trouble and needs to get better. Bob Nightingale, their mouthpiece at many times, a guy that, in fairness, is plugged in as well as anybody in the country to White Sox business, shared that thought a week earlier on this unnamed radio station, on this unnamed radio show. that is only worried about clicks and ratings. And we have Bob regularly. We have John Heyman regularly. They tell the truth based on information that they report. So this wasn't a figment of anybody's imagination. This wasn't manufactured. I get where he's coming from, but frankly, it's probably not going to be his question to answer.